please welcome Novi, Andriany, Teguh.
Okay, good afternoon, everyone. Today, I will talk about how the cities are sinking. So in this topic, I will try to make you aware about this phenomenon, and then we can also see what already done regarding this phenomenon and what can we do to help stop this phenomenon to happen. Okay, so first, I want to ask you these questions. Did you know any of this fact written here? So the first one is Jakarta is the fastest sinking city in the world. And there is research based on a model that 95% of North Jakarta will be submerged by the year of 2050. This is also related to the pipe water coverage, which is remains at only 64% in Jakarta. And also not only Jakarta, the northern part of Java Island also sinking, which is cover Pekalongan, Semarang, and Demak. Let's talk about how does it happen. So actually, there is no clear explanation about which possible causes is the biggest causes, but there are four possible causes. First is the soil composition. Second one is the tectonic movements. The third one is the increasing population and industry. And the last one is excessive groundwater extraction because of digging wells. You can see that the first two possible causes is related to the activity of the movements of our Earth, right? But the third and the fourth possible causes are related to our human activities. How is increasing population and industry can make this land subsidence happens? And how is the excessive groundwater extraction, including digging wells, also make this happens? This is also related to how is the pipe water coverage in Jakarta, which is only 64%, makes some of the people takes the water, not from the pipe water, but from digging their own wells. So because of a lot of population increase means increasing in demands of the water, and it means that excessive groundwater extraction will also occur. And now we can see how is the history of this phenomenon. So in 16th century, during the period of Netherlands expansion in Indonesia, they divided Batavia into parts based on its races living there. So there are European, Chinese, and other ethnic living there. And they are living around a canal, just like a type of Dutch city. They did it over a century. In the next century, they did nothing to the canals. They did no maintenance to the canals. So it makes the canals is polluted and sedimented. So the flow is not flowing. The water in the canal is not flowing. And it makes the canal full of disease. For example, like malaria, dengue fever, etc. Because of a lot of disease right there, the Dutch decided to leave the canals and they moved to the southern part of Batavia. So in the southern part of Batavia, they started building their new homes, and there they started to build pipe water. So they are no longer use the canals for water resource. They started using water pipe. But it's only limited to the southern part area where the, it's related to the where they live. And in the other area where the enslaved people live, in kampungs, they still doesn't have access to pipe water. So they started digging their own well. They also take the water sometimes from the polluted canals until in the 19th centuries till today. That's why there are a lot of people take water from the groundwater because the water pipe access is still not covered 100% of the area. So this is what happens if you take the water from the groundwater using pumping wells. So the right one is the normal aquifer, and the left one is the aquifer when you take the water from the groundwater. So you can see that the water becomes decreasing because of a lot of water coming out from the pump, and it makes the depression cone is also sinking. And it also makes the groundwater table is also decreasing. So that's what happens if you take a lot of water from groundwater using pumping wells. So if you had a hard time understand this, just imagine the soil as sponge. So if you have sponge and then you pour the water above your sponge, of course it will be absorbed. So the sponge is the soil. The water is, for example, rainfall water. And then after that, when you press the soil, when you press the sponge, of course, it will be harder when you press a wet sponge compared to when you press a dry sponge. So that's what happened in soil. When there are a lot of water inside your soil, like this, it will be harder to press, and it will not subside that much. It will not decrease. But if you have less water in your soil, then when there are a lot of force above the soil, it will easily be subsides. So this is the current status of access to clean pipe water in Jakarta. You can see that here, Jakarta has 13 river, but the problem is the water, the rainfall water, which is coming from the cloud, is not restored there. So it's only flowing through the river and then going into the sea. And they only have 64% coverage of pipe water access. It's actually already increased compared to 2015 and 1959. And Pamjaya, the one who regulates the pipe water in Jakarta, has a commitment to make it 100% by 2030. So we can see maybe in the future, the pipe water access in Jakarta will cover 100% so they can use less groundwater. And this one is the current status of land subsidence in Jakarta. This is a research by Netherlands researchers in Deltares in 2011. So we have a year from 1974 until 2010. You can see during 36 years, the maximum land subsidence happened is 4.1 meters. So in average, the land subsides. For example, in 1 year, it's around 10 centimeters if we make it average. But there are a lot of area with more land subsidence than the other. So yeah, it subsides quite a lot. And not only land subsidence, we have also sea level rise problems. So if we compare sea level rise problems with land subsidence, actually sea level rise is not that big. So a lot of people said that sea level rise because of the climate change makes the Jakarta is flooding. Yes, but it's not that big if the land subsidence is not happen. So you can see that the sea level from the year 1989 compared to the year 2025, they forecast it, it's around 10 centimeter rise. But in land subsidence, we can have 10 centimeter subsides in just 1 year. So you can compare that sea level rise is not that much compared to land subsidence. But if we mix them up, so the sea level rise and land subsidence happening at the same time, so it can make a bigger impact, which is tidal flood. So when the floodings happen, which is coming from the sea, so seawater floods, it means the tidal floods happen, it's because of the sea level rise mixed with the land subsidence problems. And how about the future? So the future projection of sinking Jakarta, researchers from Bandung Institute of Technology already predicted that, yeah, in the year 2050, we can see that almost all of the area of North Jakarta will be submerged below the sea level. So you can see that 35.6% of whole Jakarta, which is almost 95% of North Jakarta, will be submerged by the year of 2050. This will happen if we just keep it as it is, we did nothing, and then yeah, the sea level rise becomes bigger, the climate change becomes worsens, and the people keep using groundwater as their main source of water supply. So what has been done by the governments, especially to save the city, which is sinking? We can see that there are two big projects which already been done and currently still been doing. The first one is building Great Wall of Jakarta, Giant Sea Wall. So the Giant Sea Wall, because the initial problem is the sinking of the coastal area, so they try to save it by building a Great Wall. But guess what? The wall is also sinking because they build it in the soil which is subsides. And the second effort, I think you are all aware with this one, moving the capital from Jakarta to Borneo. So moving the capital, if they only move the governmental officers or governmental buildings, it doesn't change the fact that people in Jakarta still using groundwater for the water supply. So it can change the fact that Jakarta will still sinking even though they change the capital from Jakarta to Borneo. And what should we do? So because of this fact that two projects is not enough to save the city, we can think another solution. First one, free coastal area from housing. For example, by building mangroves. So mangroves has already potential to save the coastal area from erosion, to prevent the more water from eroded the sea area. So it's better to plant mangroves than building houses in the coastal area. And pipe water for all population, not only just now they only cover 60% of the population, but yeah, we all hope that their hopes to cover 100% in 2030 will be become reality. And continuing the second solution, the third one would be shutting down the private wells. So if the pipe water coverage already cover 100% of the area, then we don't need private wells anymore. We don't need to pump water from the ground. And in that way, we can preserve our groundwater. And to make it better, the fourth solution will be the most advanced, artificial groundwater recharge. So we can recharge the groundwater, which water has been taken from them, by using, for example, another surface water, and maybe from the rainfall that we already harvested. Last but not least, my final remarks, let's protect our groundwater. Thank you very much for listening. I hope you enjoy the rest of the show.